Hello everyone. The next algorithm that we are going to study is a buffer algorithm or a buffer method. Okay, so we have completed backfest detection algorithm and z buffer method. Okay, and I've told you that backfest detection algorithm is an object space method that is mostly used to pre-process the entire scene so that we can pass it to other visible surface detection algorithm. So the backfest detection algorithm is one such algorithm that was not detecting the visible faces, but it was able to identify the back faces that are not going to be rendered, and it approximately removes the 50% of the surfaces that are back faces. So every visible surface detection algorithm that we have started or we are going to study use this backfest detection algorithm as the pre-processing step, where most of the back faces that are never going to be rendered are already removed. Okay. And after that, on the remaining surfaces, we apply the visible surface algorithm. Okay. So last we have covered z buffer method, where we have seen the cases where solid objects or opaque objects were placed in such a fashion that one object may restrict the view of the other object. Okay, so since backfest detection algorithm was not able to detect such scenarios, so we have used z buffer method, where we have worked on the depth values, that is the z values of surfaces, and we have maintained a buffer that holds the depth values of the surfaces every pixel, and based on the z values of those pixels, we decide which surface would be closer to the view plane and that surface would be rendered. Okay. So now the next algorithm is a buffer method, and this algorithm is termed as the extension of z buffer method because it also makes use of a particular separate memory requirement. That is, we need a separate memory area that we called as a buffer. So it also makes use of a buffer like the z buffer algorithm. But it removes the limitation of the z buffer algorithm. Okay, so let's start with the algorithm. The a buffer method is also known as accumulation buffer, NTLized buffer, or area average buffer method. Mostly we use the term a buffer method, but this a represents so many things here, and mostly we call it as a buffer because the name is accumulation buffer. Okay, so accumulation means this particular algorithm works for the transparent surfaces. Okay, so for transparent surfaces such as these three surfaces, here we are having three surfaces, S1, S2 and S3, and assume that all these three surfaces are transparent in nature. Okay. So all these three surfaces are transparent in nature. So we cannot apply z-buffer algorithm here because z-buffer is only applicable to calculate the intensity value of the closest surface to the buffer. Okay. So if these surfaces would have been opaque, in that case, ye jo overlapping area aapka, in this overlapping area, we must store the intensity value for the surface S1, because in that case only S1 would be visible and this area would be not visible. This overlapping, wherever overlapping is happening, those area would not be visible. But since these three surfaces are transparent, so in these overlapping area, when we try to render them, in these overlapping area, these particular the pixels inside these overlapping area will have the accumulation of all the overlapping surfaces for that particular pixel. For example, if I consider this particular area, this much, okay. So in this particular area, surfaces S1 and, okay. So for this particular area, the pixel values or the pixel intensity would have been accumulated, would have to be accumulated, okay, in order to render it in a better way, okay. So that's what a buffer algorithm does. Why do we use it? Because Z buffer has limitation. मैंने बताई दिया आपको कि Z buffer की जो limitation है वो ये है कि for transparent objects it cannot accumulate the multiple surface intensities to a single pixel. Okay. Now a buffer method is extension of Z buffer method that can calculate the accumulation of different surfaces intensity over a specific area in case of overlapping transparent surfaces. Like it said, these are the overlapping transparent surfaces, and for a particular overlapping area, the a buffer is able to calculate the accumulation of all the overlapping surfaces for a particular area or a pixel, to be precise. In a buffer method, each position in buffer can reference a linked list of a surface. Basically, for Z buffer method, we had only one field, that is the depth values for a particular pixel. So in Z buffer algorithm, in buffer we have only the Z values for the particular pixel. While in a buffer method, every position in a buffer will contain two information, hence it will have two fields. One is depth field and second is intensity. Now, what are these values or what are these field store? First, depth field. Depth field holds a positive or negative real number. Okay, so in depth field, we will have negative or positive value. Okay. And so there has to be a real number. That number has to be either positive or negative. And corresponding that depth field, we will have an intensity field that will hold a surface intensity information or a pointer value. Okay, so I'll explain this in detail now. For positive value of depth field, okay, so I have said that this depth field will have either a negative real number or a positive real number. So in the case of positive value, so if the depth field we are representing with a D, if the value of D is positive, that means greater than zero, it will indicate that on that particular area, we are dealing with a single surface. That means if we apply a buffer algorithm in this scenario, so all these non-overlapping area for all these three surfaces, for example, for this surface, for this triangle, there are these portions that are non-overlapping, okay? So all these surfaces have some portion that are not overlapping with other surfaces. So in those cases, the D value would be always greater than zero. And that means in those portions, the corresponding pixel will have only the intensity value of those pixels. Okay. So here, what we are saying that if the D is greater than zero, then I of surface. That means if we are talking about the surface S1. So yahan par abhi maine color isliye kiya hai, red, green, blue. For the simplicity sake, for all the non-overlapping area of S1, the D value, if D value would be, obviously D value would be positive for the non-overlapping area. And in the corresponding intensity field, we will have the intensity as red only. Okay. So we can only see red color there. Okay. Now if D is greater than zero, so if D is greater than zero, then negative value of depth field indicates multiple surfaces are contributing to the pixel intensity. Now for D is less than zero, that means for negative value, we will consider the case of overlap. So in the overlapping scenario, this is a green surface and this is a black surface. So for this particular area, okay, for this particular area where my cursor is moving, where I'm pointing the cursor, for this particular area, the intensity of green surface and intensity of red surface, both would be contributing for this particular overlapping area. And for this particular area, all the three surfaces intensity would be considered. Okay, so how do we accumulate the intensity of more than one surface in a intensity field? For that, the A buffer basically used linked list as a data structure. So if D is less than zero, so the next field would be a pointer and it will point towards the surface. Okay, the first surface that is overlapping, if there are obviously there would be more than one surfaces in the case of overlapping surfaces, so it will have S1. Okay, so this field have information about the this particular S1 will have the information about that surface, and the other field for this surface linked list or this will point to the next surface. Okay, so it will goes on until we cover all the surfaces. Okay, so it is clear that in the case of negative intensity, multiple surfaces needs to be considered. Okay, and we maintain a linked list where the linked list will point to the surfaces that will be participating in that particular overlap. Okay, ab what this surface field is told, basically how do we decide the intensity of the pixels that are lying on the overlapping field? So that depends on the surface information on the overlapping area. Okay, so the surface field will have the following information. First, surface identifier. So we'll in the case of overlapping surfaces, we need to provide the identifiers IDs for every surface. So the surface will field will store the surface identifier. Also surface depth, that means the Z value for the surface for that particular area or pixel position. Percentage of transparency, it will also contribute that how transparent the surface is. Okay, either it is very transparent or it is less transparent, it will also affect the view of the particular overlapping area. Okay, so kaisa effect aapko dikhna chahiye, yes pe depend karega ki depth percentage of transparency pe, ya fir you can have percentage of opacity also, percentage of coverage area. Okay, how much area is covered or how much area is overlapped by a single surface. Okay, RGB intensity component, that will require obviously for the intensity, and we might consider other surface information that may be required. Now it is not necessary that all the surfaces has to be transparent to apply the A buffer algorithm. This is not necessary. This can be a situation that in background we have a opaque surface, okay, and in foreground we have a transparent surface. So to see through this particular transparent surface, this particular overlapping area has to accumulate the intensity information of both the background and foreground surface. Okay, so that's what we do with the A buffer algorithm.